A new DLC, new features, and most importantly, dogs. The end. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe. No, wait. Even though all you care about is dogs, we still have to talk about what's in the update. Vaults of the Ancients. This update comes with three new commendations. Under the Gold Hoarder Reputation tab, Hoarder of the Vault Keys, Finding 3 Vault Keys, and the other more important ones required to get the two new sales from Larina. Seeker of Ancient Vaults by opening 10 vaults, and Hoarder of Ancient Tributes by selling 3 ancient chests. This will be a step-by-step guide on how to complete the vault, so you can get your hands on the new cosmetics. Fuzzy here, bringing you honest guides and gameplays, so sit back, relax, and enjoy. During the Haunted Shores update, a new voyage was added, the Ghost Fleet Voyage for the Order of Souls, and you had two types, a free one from the Duke, and a harder one to purchase from the Order of Souls faction. Now, the focus has shifted towards the Gold Hoarder. You can buy the new Ancient Vaults Voyage from any Gold Hoarder or the newcomer, Larina. And if you're wondering where Duke is, he had no luck with the Tavern Lady, so trying out with Umbra instead on Lagoon of Whispers. For the new voyage, you must find several torn pieces of a map containing the location of the Vault Key. Once acquiring the key, you can either sell it to the Gold Hoarders or aim for a greater reward by heading towards the vault. Now, how to find these torn pieces? Once you vote for the voyage, you'll receive a quest item, which is the Wayfinder Compass. It will show a moving indicator towards areas to dig. These are the map pieces' locations. Even though you can figure out which island it is from the first part, the X marks the spot is only on the last piece, which contains the vault key. Now the wayfinder moves left and right, so stay in a fixed direction and look at the center distance between the furthest sides. The center indicates the island on where the maps are. Once reaching the location, follow the wayfinder until it starts spinning. This means you are standing on top of it, and time to dig. Once you find all pieces, head to the final island to dig out the vault key. But keep in mind, while digging the map pieces or the vault key, skeletons similar to the ones on Tribute Peak will spawn. Make sure to kill them as they have a chance of dropping trinkets. Now you have two options, either sell the vault key or aim for a greater reward. It will be named after an island, for example, Devil's Ridge Key. And the inscription will have a small riddle to tell you where the vault is located on that island. Once opening the vault, you again have two options. Gather as much gold as you can before the door closes, or find the three medallions to solve the puzzle. After you find them, the medallions are easy. Each one will reveal the block's required image from the left to the right. And the last fourth block will be the combination of the three in the right order. Once you get that done, press the vault button to get your chest of ancient tributes. Selling three of this will get you the ancient tribute sales. Once the door shuts, it will start filling with water, and you'll receive damage from drowning much faster than seawater. Remember, keep an eye on the vault door. Now, if you are more than one on the ship, leave one person inside the vault or more, as acquiring these gold piles will count for the whole crew. Only if you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing to help me out. And if you need crews to help you get these commendations and lots of gold, join my Discord with more than 6,000 pirates ready to set sail. As usual, see you on my Twitch streams. Fuzzy here, thank you for watching, and happy sailing.